Happy Saturday. This is our Saturday morning daily devotional. Now, first of all, I hope that you all will join us tomorrow morning on our YouTube channel for our worship gathering at 10 a.m. because you're going to get a chance to hear Aaron Palmateer. Aaron is the vice president for Missions Door, which is an organization that supports missionaries all over the globe. He's also an Arizona Ranger. That is not a baseball team. It's the law enforcement rangers in Arizona. Here's what I love about Aaron. He's super adventurous. And everybody says the same thing about Aaron all the time. That guy has crazy stories. Of course he has crazy stories. He's adventurous. And when you travel in these developing countries, these third world countries, you're going to end up with some great stories. So tomorrow morning, you're going to get to hear him share God's word with our church. Hope you'll join us. I was reading my life journal this last week, and it directed me to Romans chapter 14. And this is where Paul reveals how he thinks about himself when life gets challenging, when life actually gets threatening. Hey, you and I, we're just entering another really restrictive season where it's shelter in place, right? I mean, our COVID numbers have gone up, and it's tempting when things get challenging and threatening to really get more protective. Protective of our time, protective of our safety, protective of our family. And I want you to see how Paul views his life. This is how Romans 14, 7 and 8, Romans 14, 7 and 8 reads. He writes, "For none of us lives for ourselves alone, and none of us dies for ourselves alone. If we live, we live for the Lord, and if we die for the Lord." Pretty powerful, bold words from Paul. Whether we live or die, the thing that really matters is that we live with God's priorities and that we honor him. We honor Jesus in the midst of it all. I mean, that's kind of my loose translation of it. So question, did Paul really live out those principles, or was it just this kind of lofty theology that he had? In Acts chapter 21, Paul's traveling back to Jerusalem. And there's this prophet of God that comes to him. He takes Paul's belt and he ties his hands with it. He says, the owner of this belt will be bound and handed over to the Gentile authorities. He's telling Paul, if you go back to Jerusalem, you're going to be arrested and imprisoned. And everybody tries to talk Paul out of going to Jerusalem. Don't go, don't go. It's for your own good. And then Paul writes this, "Why are you weeping and breaking my heart? I'm ready not only to be bound, but also to die in Jerusalem for the name of the Lord Jesus." See, this text in Romans that we had read just a minute ago, that Paul, he's asking these two questions. Number one is this, what are you living for? Are you living just for yourself or for what Jesus wants you to do? And then he asks this question, what are you willing to risk your life for? What are you willing to risk your safety for in following Jesus? Pause for just a moment. In this season, it's really tempting to be protective of yourself, of your family, of your finances, of your time, of everything. Don't. Don't ask the question about how I could be more protective. Ask the question, how can I serve? How can I carry out this mission that Jesus wants? What does Jesus want me to do to take care of people? It's not just about our own families. It's about all those people around us that we get to serve. Check out Romans 14, 7 through 8, and see what God might show you there. God bless you. See you tomorrow morning, 10 a.m.